This is a 2025 Featherlite. Yes, you heard that right. This is a 2025 Featherlite. This is a Prevost conversion, and let me tell you something. This is absolutely the coolest motorhome you have ever seen. As of this moment, you have never seen this coach online. This build was done so privately, and at the request of the owners, everything was kept under wraps. But today, I'm going to show you some of the very unique features of this bus and give you a tour of the interior. And that starts right now on the Gadget Guru. Regular viewers of my channel probably already noticed that I haven't posted a motorhome video in quite some time. Well, that's because I've sold both of my motorhomes quite some time ago, both my 1957 flexible Starliner as well as my 2014 Marathon Prevost. And since I'm out of the lifestyle, well, I really didn't have anything to do. Well, that was until just recently when two very dear friends of mine who live out in the West Coast, they contacted me and said, we are going to be bringing our 2025 Featherlite. Yes, you heard me right. A 2025 Featherlite to Fort Wilderness right near me in Disney World in Orlando, and we'd like you to take a quick look at it. Well, I saw this thing and I said, this is definitely video worthy. This is the most outrageous and gorgeous motorhome you have ever seen. So let's go in and take a quick look. On the paint was done by Prevost, but it was custom spec by the two owners of this, and they just really did a phenomenal job. Now, you've seen motorhome paint, beauty is in the eye of the beholder. I don't have to go through that. When we get to the inside, you're gonna see some things you've never seen on a motorhome. But let me just show you a few basic things here. Okay, you open this up, and like other motorhomes, you have your center here. Here, let me get the remote control, and watch this. Oops. I have to point this here. It has to be in line of sight, and that keeps it from opening accidentally. You have your refrigerator down here. They have a barbecue grill that pops on up here, but look how wide this thing comes out, or how deep it comes out. You have all the space back here. You have additional storage space underneath. You have drawers, just about everything you need. Here, let me go in and pull that back in. This thing is just, you know, And again, as you'll see when we go inside, the woodworking, the colors and everything on here are just gorgeous on here. Let's get that out of the way and I'll go in and move over to the next door because this is interesting too. Now over here, what you have, and this is completely different from every other Prevost that I've seen, this is where the generator bay is. Well, you're gonna see why when we get to the other side, they replace that, those area over there with other features that you haven't seen. But I was told that this made a lot of sense because with the slides, and this is a two-slide coach, being on the other side, this kind of helps balance out the weight. And we all know how important weight management is on a large motorhome, even a small motorhome, it's important. Now, you see these fins over here? Well, this has bus air plus 4 roof ACs. What's good about the bus air, while it does require the engine to be on, these people live out in the desert Southwest, and it gets hot, you know, 120 degrees in the summer. This can cool down a heat-soaked coach in just a matter of minutes, much faster than what it would take with the roof airs. Now let's go in and go over to the other side and I'll show you what else is unique. Now this has to be one of my favorite features on this coach. I have never seen this before. Check this out. Remember I said how the generator usually is over here, at least it was on my bus. Over here, this is a water bay, but I know it's gonna be difficult to see here. Back here is a complete reverse osmosis system, you know, for your, you know, the water for the whole bus. Now, let me tell you why this system is different from others that I've ever seen. I'm gonna move out of the way here so don't continue to hit my head. Most water filtration systems you see on motorhomes, whether it's a standard canister or even some who do use reverse osmosis, it typically only goes to your sink in your galley. You know, I was shocked in my motorhome that it didn't even go to the built-in ice maker for the refrigerator, so I didn't use it. You know, we made our own with our own ice with bottled water. But what's unique about this is that every drop of water that goes into the coach is completely filtered. It is a marine grade system. It's very similar, if not the same thing, as a desalinization unit that you would use on very, very high-end luxury yachts, where they take seawater and then they bring it down where it's consumable to drink. Well, every faucet outlet in this whole bus, including the shower and the toilet, is completely filtered. And this is just a system that is just wonderful. And of course, Featherlite has complete systems with remote controls. They have 16 panels where you can control everything indoors or outdoors. For example, you know how nice it would be? I know I would have loved to have had this, where I could control my slides not only indoors but outdoors. So when you get into a tight space such as this one at Disney's Fort Wilderness, you know that you're not going to hit anything. Now, let's go on the other side. I want to show you one thing that is missing. And let me be accurate. Two things that are missing on this bus. Now, as I told you right up front, this coach has just about everything on it you can imagine. In fact, it does. There's a few things that are missing. Let's start right over here. Notice what's missing over here? There's no docking lights. You know, usually you have docking lights that kind of litter up the side of the coach here. And you need those because when you're at night, you need to be able to see all the way down here. Well, they've been replaced. Featherlite has come up with a very unique method of these type of LED lights. These things are like torches and they're located in multiple positions around the coach. Now, they can act as running lights and amber and even turn signals. But when you hit that docking button, they come out and they really flood the area. Now, here's another thing that's missing. Tell me if you've noticed this yet. There's no mirrors. The mirrors are gone. They've been replaced with these cameras. Let me go inside and I'm going to show you how that works. And as you see, as I walk into the field of view of the cameras up here that are mounted outside, you can see it's a wide field of view. It's clear. And I spoke to my friends who have driven us both in day and night. You know, they've only had the bus for a few weeks now. They said that during the day, it is crystal clear. It is clearer than what you would see in the glass mirrors. And at night, the image is bright. And they're telling me they feel it's much safer. The other benefit, it's quieter. You don't have those large mirrors on there picking up wind noise, depending on which way the wind is blowing and which way you're heading. This is really the shape of things to come. And Prevost is, I believe, the first motorhome manufacturer to give the option, if you're building a new coach, and I think on newer coaches, you can even have them retrofitted, to replace the outside mirrors with these cameras. Now let's go take a look on the inside. Pardon the interruption, but I just wanted to jump in for a moment to give myself a plug. As you know, I like to record and put my personal hobbies up on my YouTube channel, and lately I've been recording a series of fun slot machine videos at the Hard Rock Casinos in Florida, both Hollywood and Tampa. My friend David and myself have some really fun slot machine videos, so I hope you check us out. Yeah, like, share, subscribe, and all that fun stuff. Now, let's get back to checking out the interior of this gorgeous 2025 Featherlite Luxury Motor Coach. While I'm in the cockpit, I just want you to take a look around. Now, granted, this is a Prevost, but what makes it different? Each converter does their cockpit a little bit different. I really like the way that Featherlite does this. Everything down to their AMG-style air conditioning vents, to the way they do the layouts, the multiple screens. Look at the way they have done the steering wheel, with the texture around the center there. And of course, you got to talk about the stitching. The stitching on here, all the leather work is just gorgeous. Now let's go take a look inside the salon. Now, I don't know about you, but this is nicer than most homes here. Check this out in here. The quality of the leather and the materials that you see on this specific coach are nicer than anything I've ever seen. And the textures, this is the same thing you just saw on the steering wheel. You have the silhouette shades on here so you can, you know, have multiple layers of privacy while letting light in. Over here, most of the electrical outlets also have high-powered USB-Cs on here. You can power a laptop on here without needing an adapter. It's just everything they've done in here is totally first class. And the ceiling treatment, this is absolutely unique, and I love how they've built the ventilation and everything in here without it being noticed, as well as the lighting and the speaker systems. Now let's go take a look at the galley, because this is really unique. Okay, when you look at the sink right here, this is from Frankie. Now this is designed where this can pull back and go up and give you multiple layers of workspace in your sink. It's a quartz sink on the inside. And remember what I said about the water system they have outdoors? Every faucet, including the shower, the toilet, which you'll see in a minute, is all purified water. Yes, you can drink out of your toilet. I don't think we're going to do that today. Now, let's take a look at some of the appliances that my friends chose to put in their bus. Down here, of course, you have your trash bin and storage over here. Open up here. They did not want to go with the standard Fisher Paykel, however you pronounce that, dishwasher. They went with a Miele, whatever it is. And this is like a residential dishwasher, but it's a much higher quality than what you'll see on most buses. Now, the other thing I want to point out when it comes to, and like even the attention, the detail that they did on the drawers here, Featherlite. And I don't know if other coach manufacturers do this. I know that Marathon didn't do this, and it was a major source of frustration for me. They use a bayonet system on all their drawers, both indoors and outdoors. And what that does, as soon as you start the coach and release your parking brake, you hear that sound. And that sound is the bayonets going through to lock them in where you cannot open the drawers. And then you can hit one button, you can unlock it, and it opens up here. Now, of course, over here in the dinette, they decided to go with the L shape here. This can move in and out for space. And I think I did point out this is a two-slide coach. And here's what's interesting about this. My friends had a four-slide Newmar King Air. And they were, when they started shopping for Prevost, they were saying four-slide. But then Featherlite gave them an opportunity to use a two-slide coach for a while they were waiting for this to be built. And they changed their mind. They said, you know, the way that Prevost are built, this is different from your typical motorhome. And they said, this is going to give us more than enough interior space, and it's going to give us additional storage space. And as you can see, there's plenty of room here. Now, we got to move over here because you got to see some of this stuff. Now, I'm not even going to attempt to pronounce the name of this refrigerator, but they went with a laborer. Now, my friends are just very detailed in everything they did. And they said in some of the refrigerators they've seen or had on motorhomes, they just don't keep the vegetables fresh that long. This thing is great. And of course, you have the ice maker, of course, going through the filtration system. You have dual freezers down here. But when you get over here, Gaggenau, this is a full steam oven. This is a coffee maker, and down here, a convection oven. Now, you have to hit some buttons to open it up. I don't remember how to do it. So we're going to go in and move back here because you have to see the head or the lavatory, whatever you want to call it. What they decided to go with, instead of, they didn't need a bath and a half. They wanted to go a larger full bath in the center in between the kitchen and the master bedroom. Now, this shower is absolutely unique. Not only are the mirrors heated, because you're using the special water, remember I showed you that tank outside, you don't get water spots in here. It's just like if you're washing your car with it, but the water is clean for consumption. Check this out up there. You have a flush-mounted shower head. You have your speakers. You even have a heated bench in here. But the tile work on this is great. It's all German fixtures in here. Everything in here is top quality. Now, when you start looking at the individual pieces on here, I've seen some motorhomes that have some unique items in here, but none that have checked off every box like this one. Now, we got to take a look at the toilet. This is something everybody would love. First of all, look at the position of the toilet. You have plenty of knee room. That's not the case in all motorhomes. But this is like a Toto bidet. What do they call it here? It's called the washlet. It is completely electric and all the stuff it does. You have the heated, you have the sprayers, everything else. Now, they have dogs. If the dogs choose to drink out of the toilet, it is completely purified through the reverse osmosis water system. Look over the mirror. Yes, that mirror is heated too. But wait, there's more. You gotta check out the bedroom. As I said, but wait, there's more. Take a look at this right here. This is your washer dryer. Again, a Miele. They went top quality on everything that they put in here. The woodwork in this is just phenomenal. I love the blue and the natural dark wood look in here. It's just great. You have the soundbar above, a 65-inch TV for the bedroom. Roman shades. When you go over here, okay, they like to use drawers more than hanging closets, so they built in plenty. These right here are important. Each of these handle sets weigh 10 pounds each. They really feel good. You have your closet storage here. You have storage for things you need to keep everything clean, and even more. Now, of course, you have all the different, you know, as I said before, the USB-Cs, you have everything under the bed. Roman shades back here. They decided to go with the upholstered headboard here. And I got to tell you, I kind of agree with that, because I know when I had my Prevost, that when I was in the bedroom, I was sleeping. I did not need people to be looking in. With the TV here, the headboard here, this is like your bedroom in your home. Now let me go inside, and I'm going to tell you how they decided to go with this coach, and I'll give you some closing thoughts. Now let me point out, this is not a commercial for Featherlite, but let me tell you how this coach came to be. The two guys that own this, they've been dear friends of mine for a lot of years. When I was exploring my different motorhome purchases, well, they already had one motorhome, then they were going to another one. They ended up with a Newmar King Air. I had my vintage bus then, and then I got my 2014 Marathon Prevost. And we were talking about the pros and cons and everything. When they finally decided, okay, it's time to step up, we had talked about concepts that they wish they had bought their last coach first. But when you look back on it, if this would have been their first coach, they wouldn't have known half of what to do with it. They've now lived with two coaches. They know what features and functions are important to them. They know the layout that works for them. Now, when they decided that they wanted to finally get serious about a Prevost, they came down to visit me in Florida. We sat down and you know, at the dining room table, we were talking about this, and they had already made the decision. They're going to go visit the various converters. And, you know, in Florida, you have quite a few of them down there. They had things on their list. And the most important thing was they did not want to buy somebody else's concept of what a luxury motorhome should be. They wanted to design it, and they knew this would be up to a two-year process to do, and they were going to be patient. They also knew it was going to be expensive. If I haven't said the price, well, you know, there's not everything that we want to make public, but I'll tell you, it is north of $3 million for this coach. And when you start looking at all the details, if you can re-experience this up hand, you will understand what I mean. Well, they visited the different coach converters. And when they talked about, okay, they want to do custom, and all of them said they would do custom. Well, custom means different things to different people. To most converters, it means, okay, you can pick the type of floor. You can pick, you know, if you want a certain type of fabric or a certain type of leather. But the layouts pretty much were converter specific. There were some leeway that you could do a little bit here, a little bit there. But then they went up to go see Featherlite, and they sat down and they said, we know, and they met with Jimmy Adams and a few others up there in Virginia. And they said, we know what we want to do, and we don't want to do things normal. We want to use some appliances that we've never seen in motorhomes. We want the reverse osmosis system. We want the pressure washer, which I forgot to show you down there. They already have built in with the reverse osmosis system. And by the way, that works similar to a deionized water, so you can wash your vehicles with it and be spot free. And Featherlite was the only one that said, we'll let you start with a blank sheet of paper. You just need to decide how many slides you want. And once we go from there, we see how much space, we'll build it out from there. The process from the day they made the commitment to the day they took delivery, which was just a week or so ago, was approximately 2 years. And this is what Featherlite is calling their first 2025 Prevost motorhome. So now the rest is up to you. What do you think about this coach? And if you could, take a moment and check out my YouTube channel, because you'll see what I've been up to lately. You know, I like to put my hobbies online, and my most recent one is slot machine videos. So if you like slot machine videos, you're going to love these new videos. So I hope you stay tuned, like, subscribe, and all that fun stuff. That's it for now. I'm the Gadget Guru, Andy Parr.